Hey guys, it's Ms. Simpson and it's time for math today. We are going to be reviewing shapes together, how to classify shapes and how to classify triangles. So let's go ahead and let's start off with the easy one, and it is triangles. We can classify triangles two ways, by side or by angle. The one that I'm most concerned about this year for you in fourth grade is by angle. So we have an acute, a right, or an obtuse triangle. An acute triangle has three angles that are acute. So if it's an acute triangle, all three angles are an acute angle. Then we have a right triangle. Only one right angle. So not all of the angles are right angles, only one. And same for obtuse, only one of the angles is an obtuse angle. So remember, obtuse is when it is bigger than a right angle. It's larger than 90 degrees. Acute is smaller than 90 degrees, smaller than a right angle. And a right angle makes 90 degrees. It's like an L on your hand. Okay, so now I want to review back over with you how we can classify our shapes. And we always use this flowchart, and I'm going to post the flowchart and the triangles anchor chart right down below to refresh your memory when you're doing your assignment today. So a quadrilateral is a polygon, and a polygon is just about any shape and that has four sides and four angles. So if you see a shape and it has four sides and four angles, it's a polygon. It's a quadrilateral. Now a triangle has three sides, right? Quadrilateral has four because quad means four. So any shape with four sides and four angles is a quadrilateral. Then once you decide if it has four sides and four angles, you've got to decide, is it a parallelogram or a trapezoid? Well, if it has one pair of parallel sides, it's a trapezoid. And if it has two pairs of parallel sides, it's a parallelogram. Then you've got to look and see, is it a rectangle with four right angles or a rhombus with four sides of equal length? And if it has both, that means it is a square with four right angles and four sides of equal length. So what I do is I go through that checklist in my head as I'm looking at a shape. So I say, okay, quadrilateral at the top has four right angle or four angles and four sides. It doesn't matter if it's all funky looking like this one is, it just has four angles and four sides. Then I think about the parallel and parallel lines. Does it have one pair or two? Then I go to my angles and my sides, and that's how I classify those shapes. So today we are actually going to do some practice star test questions. These questions are directly off of the star test, and to kind of get what you are going to see. To kind of get what you are going to see on your test here in a few weeks. So let's go ahead and let's read this. Lisa drew a figure on the front of her notebook that has two obtuse angles. Which figure could be the one Lisa drew? So think about it. A rectangle. Now, if I draw a rectangle has four right angles. It even says it in our flow chart. Four right angles. So guess what? It can't have two obtuse angles because it has four right. An obtuse triangle. An obtuse triangle from our anchor chart, it only has one obtuse angle. So it can't have two. A parallelogram? I don't know. Remember, a parallelogram, all that is said about a parallelogram is it has two pairs of parallel sides. And to me, this looks like a obtuse and this looks obtuse. So maybe in a right triangle. And a right triangle can only have, that's not even a right triangle. A right triangle only has one right angle. So it has to be H. So like I said, just go through that flow chart in your head. Which triangle appears to be an acute triangle? Now remember, an acute triangle has three acute angles. So I want you right now to pause the video and figure out which one you think is the correct answer. I know that this is obtuse, so it can't be F. This is acute, this is acute, and this is acute. I'm going to check the others. This looks like a right angle. And this is definitely obtuse. So it is G. All right, let's look at this one. Oh, we're not on perpendicular yet. Not that one. Only one more. Four figures are shown below. Which figures appear to be rectangles? Now, guys, the only classification for rectangles is four right angles. So we can rule out the ones that do not have right angles. This one doesn't have four right angles, and this one doesn't have four right angles. So I only am left with figure P and figure R. So which one am I going to pick? C, figure P and R. So today, you are going to complete a fast focus. When you complete this fast focus, please take a look at your flow chart when it asks you about things. Also, look at the triangles anchor chart if you do not remember how to do things. So I am going to mark out a couple of these just so you have a little bit less to do. But just do your very best. All right. I love you guys so much. Remember to go through your flow chart just like I taught you. Check and see with all the parallelograms and all of that. This is one of the harder ones to teach only because it's all about memorization. So if you don't memorize the different types of shapes, it's really hard for me to tell you how to do these problems because I can't help you work them out. You just kind of got to know. So use your anchor charts, check back on them, and just do your best. All right. I